So the second topic is respiration. So in the first topic we learned how we get nutrients from the food. So how the food gives nutrients? Food after breaking down, it provides energy. So this process is known as respiration. So is only food enough to release energy? No. So food, what are the things we need to get energy? Food, aid, that is oxygen, and some chemicals. We need some chemicals also. So these three involved in the process of respiration and releases energy. So the word respiration came from the Latin word respire, which means to breathe. That is gaseous exchange. So now the respiration. What are the parts involved in this respiration? So there are different parts involved. So these all parts are known as respiratory system. So the different parts in the respiratory system are, so let us see the steps in respiration. Breathing, gaseous exchange at lungs level, next blood, tissue, and cellular. Cellular means the exchange takes place between the cell and the blood. So these are the steps. And before going to the process, let us know about the parts of the respiratory system. So respiratory system, what are the different parts in this? As you seen in the picture, the first one is nostrils. Next comes nasal cavity. Pharynx. So first one is nostrils. So you see the course of the nose through which we take the air. And next is nasal cavity. That is the cavity inside the nose, which is the surface is moist and it has some hair also. So these two help to filter the tiny dust particles in the air. And also this moist helps the air to get the moist, and also the air in this cavity, it gets the temperature which is near to our body temperature. And the next one is pharynx. So pharynx is the junction of esophagus and trachea. So from this part, the respiratory system and the digestive system starts. So here pharynx, a special part is present, which is known as epiglottis. So it is a flap-like structure, muscular flap-like structure. What is the function of the epiglottis? So when we take the food, the epiglottis closes. So the food doesn't enter to the respiratory tract or the trachea. And when we take the air, the epiglottis opens. So the air really moves to the trachea. So that is the help of epiglottis. And the next part is larynx. So larynx, the vocal cords are present. So when we breathe out, the air passes through these vocal cords, which are helpful to produce the sounds when we speak or sing. So that is larynx. And it opens to the next part, trachea. So trachea is nothing but it is a windpipe. You see, C-shaped cartilaginous rings are present, which support the windpipe. When the wind moves, when we take in the air or sense out, the cartilaginous rings strengthen this windpipe. So this trachea, when it enters to the thoracic cavity, it splits into two pipes known as bronchi. It opens into, it further divides into small tubules. Those are called as bronchioles. These bronchioles open into the lungs. So in the lungs, as you observe, we have two lungs, right one and left one. The right lung is little bigger than the left one. As we have heart at the left side, the left one is little smaller. So in the lungs, we observe sacs-like structures, alveoli. Structural and functional parts of the lungs. So alveoli, if you observe the structure of the alveoli, it appears so. It is a sac-like structure and it has the cell wall, which is single cell, and over that the capillaries are present. These are also single cell. So the gaseous exchange takes place in this alveoli. So the next part is blood. So blood transports the oxygen to the cell and takes the CO2 to the lungs. So then mechanism of respiration. It involves two phases, inhalation and exhalation. Before going to this process, let us know the parts involved in this. As lungs, they themselves cannot take in the air or sense out the air. Two parts are involved in this process. One is chest wall and diaphragm. Chest wall, that is made up of ribs, muscles and skin. That is chest cavity. And diaphragm, it is a dome-like structure which is present below the lungs. So now the process or mechanism of respiration. First one is inhalation. Inhalation means intake of air, that is intake of oxygen. So how the air comes to the lungs? So for this, the chest wall moves up or expands. So as you see in that picture, the cavity space is increased and the diaphragm it contracts, so flattened. So the space in the chest cavity is increased as shown in that picture. As the space is increased, the air from outside, it comes into the lungs. So next one is exhalation, in which the lungs has to send out the carbon dioxide. So in this, the chest wall moves inwards and the diaphragm is relaxed. So here the dome, convex side of the dome shape, it enters to the chest cavity. So the space in the cavity, it decreases, it becomes less. So the pressure on the lungs is increased. So the lungs, they send out the air. So this is exhalation. So these are the process or mechanism of respiration. This is gaseous exchange. So when we inhale, the air comes into the lungs. So from there, it enters to the alveoli. So we observe this structure of the alveoli. It is a single cell, only one cell layer thickness. The wall is one cell thickness and it is covered by the capillary. It is also single cell thickness, in thickness. So when the blood comes from the heart, it enters to the capillaries and from there it takes the oxygen from the alveoli. The blood cell takes the oxygen and it sends the carbon dioxide into the alveoli. And when we breathe out, the carbon dioxide sends out. So now the gas, the oxygen entered into the blood. So in blood, the blood cells, they contain a pigment called hemoglobin, which is iron contained pigment. So this hemoglobin, this blood cell, so the hemoglobin takes the oxygen and carries to the cell. So this is called oxyhemoglobin. So this carries the oxygen to the cell and then again from the cell it absorbs the CO2, that is known as carboxyhemoglobin, and some of the carbon dioxide it is sent out in the form of bicarbonates. So this is a gaseous exchange, it takes place in the alveoli. So when you observe the process of respiration, the food molecules are combined with oxygen and it is decomposed and we get energy. So we use the energy for our daily activities and some of the energy is liberated in the form of heat. So some energy is stored in the body as ATP, adenosine triphosphate. So here some energy is liberated in the form of heat also. So continuously we lose some heat from the body. So to cover that heat, to maintain the body temperature, we require heat, which is produced in the process of respiration. So if we can't maintain the body temperature, the biological process, they won't occur. So the energy released is known as ATP, which is known as energy currency. So these all processes occur in the cell level. So it is known as cellular respiration. actually we know the air comes to the lungs from there to the alveoli, and from there the blood takes the oxygen to the cell. So ultimately the oxygen reaches to the cell. Here it combines with the food and then the energy is released. So the process is occurs at the cellular level. It is known as cellular respiration. So now types of respiration. So basing on the utilization of oxygen, the respiration is two types. One is aerobic respiration and anaerobic respiration. So anaerobic respiration, you can observe this in the bacteria. So these, they don't need oxygen. So they convert the food material into some acids. Generally, lactic acid is formed and some energy is formed. Less amount of energy is formed in anaerobic respiration. So these are conducted by some bacteria, fungi, bacteria. So next one is aerobic respiration. They take the oxygen for this process. So in this, the food material completely dissolved and carbon dioxide, water and high amount of energy is released. Generally, we can observe in all living organisms. So as we said, in anaerobic respiration, there is no need of oxygen. In human beings also, anaerobic respiration takes place in tissues. When you do strenuous work or exercise, we need more energy. So for that, more respiration is needed. So we take excess oxygen into the body, and then heat liberation also same. More excess heat is liberated. That's why we feel warm when we do heavy works or exercises. So then maybe we don't get sufficient oxygen for the respiration. Then the tissues, they perform anaerobic respiration. So inside our body. So then lactic acid is formed in the tissues. So that's why we get pains due to this lactic acid when we do exercises. So by taking some rest, we can get relief from this. So these are the two types. And basing on the parts involved in the respiration, the types of respiration are so. Depending on the habitat where the organisms live, the different respirations are we can observe. Suppose first one is diffusion. This diffusion we observe in unicellular organisms like amoeba. So they take the carbon oxygen or sends out of carbon dioxide by the same cell. So special parts are not present in that unicellular organisms. So amoeba or hydra. Hydra, even though it is multicellular, the process is diffusion. Just from the higher concentration to lower concentration, the gases moves. So next one is a tracheal respiration. Trachea means tubes. So in cockroach or in arthropods, the insects, they have blood which lacks hemoglobin. So the blood is in white color. So it is not able to transport the oxygen to the cells. So in their body, the tracheal respiration is present, in which the trachea tubes, they directly goes to the cell and they carries the oxygen or CO2. And the next one is branchial respiration. We can observe this in fishes. So in this, the respiratory organ is gills or bronchi. So we can observe this branchial respiration in fishes. So the organs are gills. These are present on either side of the head. So to take place the respiration, the gills are to be wet. So for this, the fish always it opens the mouth and closes so that the water enters and it makes the gills wet. So by that, it takes the oxygen from the water and sends out the CO2 through the gill aperture to the outside. So it is known as branchial respiration, which is occurring in fishes. Cutaneous respiration. Cutaneous means cuticle, which is otherwise known as skin. So we can observe this in annelids, that is for example earthworm, and some frogs also we can observe this respiration performed by the skins. So we can see the skin in the earthworm is very thin. We can observe the blood vessels by the naphedi. So here the respiration takes place through the skin. Gases exchange takes place through the skin. So that's why the earthworm always keeps its skin wet. And next one is pulmonary respiration. In this, the organs are lungs which perform the respiration. Most of the multicellular evolved organisms, pulmonary respiration is present. So these are the types of respiration. Now, as you learned in photosynthesis, the gaseous exchange takes place in glands through stomata. The same stomata are helpful for the respiration also. Gaseous exchange takes place through this. These are present in leaves, but in plants, stems also perform respiration through some cells which are known as lenticels. Through that, stems perform respiration, and roots also helpful for the respiration. So very thin root hairs, so this contain thin walls, so the gaseous exchange takes place in the roots also. But when the plants are grown in marshy areas or waterlogged areas, the roots cannot perform the respiration. So in that, suppose some plants, mangroves, they grow in the marshy lands. So the roots cannot perform respiration. So in this, the special roots are present, which are aerial roots. So they grow upwards. So they take oxygen from the air. So small pores are present on these roots, and it is helpful for the respiration in mangroves. So this is the process of respiration in plants. Photosynthesis versus respiration. So up to now we learnt about photosynthesis and respiration. If you observe, the respiration is quite opposite to the photosynthesis. Here it uses carbon dioxide and water and forms food. In this respiration, the food is decomposed and carbon dioxide and water is released. So in this, to form the bonds, the energy is used, the energy taking reaction, and the energy is taken from the sunlight. Here the already from the food, the energy is released by breaking the bonds. So here the energy, it is the energy releasing process of synthesis. It is the catabolic process. So here chemicals are formed. Here chemicals are burned to give the energy.